Grace, mercy, and peace to you all in the name of God our Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus. Amen. If you join me in a word of prayer. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the word that you put before us this morning. The word, Lord, that calls us to be people who live in you and who love in you. Lord, we ask that for us, for all of us this morning, that you would help us to hear, help us to listen. Send the Holy Spirit upon us that we would be guided. We ask this, Jesus, in your name. Amen. Whenever we kind of encounter the book of James, and for those of you who are visiting today, we've been working through Scripture. We're now at the book of James. Peter is coming up this next week. Whenever we encounter the book of James, whenever I encounter people and they have like a smidgen of Lutheranism in them, the one thing that people seem to remember about the book of James, about how James was supposed to work, about how James was, what Luther thought of the book of James, was that Luther didn't like it. How many of you remember hearing that? Anybody? Okay, a couple of you. You know, when Luther didn't like the book of James, he didn't like it because he thought there was some contradiction going on in between James and the works of Paul. Paul seemed like he was saying a lot about, you know, salvation is this free gift, and salvation is this thing that is given out. There's nothing that you add to this salvation. There's nothing at all. And that is absolutely sure and certainly true. The people that Paul would write to, their problem, as it were, was that they really did want to add something to salvation. They really wanted to add some qualifiers unto our salvation, and so, you know, Paul said no, absolutely not. And the difference is that in the book of James, James was writing to a people, to a troubled people, in a troubled world, in a troubled church. You know, not much has actually changed with us. He was writing to people who, in the 50s, not our 50s, but their 50s, back in the odd 50s, right? Back in the 50s, they're starting to suffer a great deal of persecution. There's corruption. There's poverty. There's injustice. You know, nothing really changes. And some of these Christians that James is writing to, they're starting to do the thing that we do as human beings. They're starting to get angry. And so he writes them primarily to say, don't resort to the ways of the world. Don't give in to the ease with which violence can come. I don't know about your life, my life, I know that violence is very easy within the human heart. Very, 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 very easy to have not just, you know, physical violence, but mental and emotional violence. It's very easy within the human heart. And so James is writing to these people who don't give into it. Don't be like the world. Don't do this. Instead, focus on the doing of good. Take the people who are poor and care for them. Take the people who are suffering and help them. This is where James is writing. And so I think James is fully fine. The salvation is won by Jesus. But then for people who are in Jesus, what do you do with him? You love. That's where James, I think, is getting to. And so he says that having this faith, or hearing without acting, is like forgetting what you look like after you look into a mirror. How many of you looked into a mirror today? Anybody look in a mirror? Some of you. I brought my own mirror today. I just want to test this out. Let's see here. Maybe I'll go all the way to the back. Like, people sit in the back because they don't want to be bothered, right? Alright, so here we are. We have a fine, willing participant. Alright, so here we are, we look at you, and now we turn the mirror. Do you remember what you look like? Unfortunately, yes. Can you describe what you look like? Can you describe your hat?
It's kind of a greenish turquoise.
What's going to go with turquoise? Okay. Right? James says it's crazy when you look in the mirror and then you turn the mirror and you forget. It's crazy. It's crazy. Like, I can look at myself and I'm like, okay. And I don't turn the mirror and say, oh, you know what lovely long blonde hair I have. It'd be crazy. This is what James is saying about us in faith. That we have seen the image of God and it has been given unto us. And it's crazy to forget it. I believe that Jesus in John 13, he's working on something very similar here as he watches these disciples feet. He reaches down, the God of the universe descends from heaven, and amongst all the other things that the God of the universe chooses to do, he chooses to reach even lower and to wash these disciples. And he says, I've done this so that you do this. I do this thing, this foot washing, this service, this place of humility, this place of giving up of yourself, not taking on all of the pretensions that he is perfectly allowed to. I do this so that you do this. Because I believe that Jesus was well aware, and James is well aware, that we are a forgetful people. We forget. I forget, you forget. Are we forgetting? Right? Only like three of us have ever forgotten. Have the rest of you forgotten that you have forgotten anything? Man, we get heated, we get full of ourselves. Sometimes we get tripping over our own tongues, and James is going to talk about that. We forget that we look like people who are washed clean by Jesus. We forget that we were washed in the blood of the Lamb. We forget that. And so Jesus sets forward this example. And James calls us back to remembering that example. That this master, this Lord, this God of the universe, what he did, we are not higher than our master. We are not more noteworthy than our Lord. We are in no way more important. Not as pastor, not as parishioner, not as nothing. We will forget. We also have the opportunity to remember. And the way in which Jesus says that you begin to remember, or at least the way in which it seems like remembering who you are and who you belong to, the way in which that happens is by serving. We remember, engaging in service helps us to remember. Like there's something fundamentally connected to giving up and offering up of yourselves. You know, there's a one guy who has a handicapped wife, and every day I see this man, he's not a Christian. Every day I see this man, and I say hi, hello, and every day he's pushing his wife in the wheelchair, all the time. And it seems like somehow this man has understood something really profound about service without understanding Jesus. And so I think James is really like, look, you who have received, How much more for you? How much more for you can you remember? Remember that we are a loved people. We are loved so that we can show love. Remember that we are people who were sacrificed for. And Jesus gave up of himself for us so that we may be a people who sacrifice. Remember that there was mercy that was waiting in the cross for us, that we may be merciful. James is all about people remembering. Remembering in days where you want to forget, where you look at the injustice and the poverty and whatever the other issues that you've got going on and you want to meet them with some sort of violence of the heart, James says, no, remember. Remember, don't be polluted by the violence of this world. Don't be polluted by that. Remember that you are of Jesus. And that as you are of Jesus, your service in the world brings blessing. I thank James for helping us to remember. Remember what Jesus was doing on that Last Supper night. Remember him washing the feet. We all, lots of us remember that. To enter into service is to help remember him in the name of this Jesus who has cleansed us with his love. Amen. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We thank you that you give us a mirror to look into. We get to see what we look like. We get to remember the stubble upon our face if we have stubble. Lord, we thank you that we get to remember who we are. So Lord, help us as we look to remember that we do not belong simply to the person in the mirror, but to the person who has washed us clean. Lord, be with us to enter into service. In your name, amen. I invite you to stand. We join in professing our faith using the words of the creed.